by a single mother who had overcome substance abuse and homelessness and was working as hard as she could to provide a loving and stable home for her son, William. She wanted nothing but the very best for him, the best education, the best opportunities, just the best. I think that she had my cell phone number on speed dial because she called me so frequently. And she knew that if she called me between 4:15 and 5 o'clock, I'd probably be driving home, and I'd have a few minutes then to chat. And we talked about things like how to write a double response journal entry, and I explained the implications of the French and Indian War, because she wanted to know what we were doing at school so that she could help him at home. As for William, he loved football and wanted to be a football player. And his mom and I agreed that was an excellent goal. But football players need to be able to read and write and do math. He loved Michael Jackson, dancing, PE, Xbox, joking around with his friends, and visiting his Uncle Bill in Washington State. When it came to academics, fifth grade was William's year. That's the year he got placed into an advanced math class. William was a GT student, which you wouldn't have known it. He had to push it because he wasn't one who was independently motivated. He liked to read in fifth grade, but he didn't like his friends to know that he was beginning to like to read. And he was secretly proud when I put it in my William and Mary reading group. He didn't like the secret garden, and he didn't want his friends to perceive him as being smart. He was a leader in small groups, but his home because when the large groups would hang back. And like most students, he was excited about coming to middle school. I knew these two people well, William and Jane. I had a relationship with these two people. But when they were killed, I was the one who was asked to speak of their services. See, the experience of delivering a eulogy for a student is not one you ever want to have. And I had to think that out of something, out of that, there was a lesson to be learned. There was a reason that this came into my life. And so I asked myself this question when I looked around my classroom. Could I stand there and could I say those things I said about William about every single one of those kids who was sitting in front of me? And the answer was sadly, but quite honestly, no, I couldn't. I couldn't stand up and do that for every kid in my class. And so my vision began to take shape then. My vision is that every one of our students comes to school and has a connection. Someone here who truly and deeply understands them and knows them. When they're not here, someone misses them. My vision is that the members of our team and people at this school will be able to talk about each and every one of our students. Because relationships are the cornerstone of the work that we have to do. I believe that all students have an opportunity to challenge with rigorous classes and being in advanced placement math like William. Regardless of their race, their family history, their economic challenges, but for that to happen, we as educators have to seek to understand all of the forces that are at play in the lives of our students. How will we tailor our instruction if we don't know our students? See, how to not understand Jane's background and where she came from and why she was so desperate for William to have more than she had had, I might have found those phone calls to be a nuisance. But because I knew, because I understood, I relished those opportunities to help her with her mission to help her son. And I pray that none of us will ever be put in that position again to have to stand up and speak at services for a student. But should that time come when one of us have to stand up and speak, and hopefully this time it's because one of our students is accepting a Nobel Peace Prize or a Congressional Medal of Honor, I hope that we will all be able to say that we knew them, that we truly knew and understood them, and that in some way we had positively impacted the person that they had become. Every student needs someone here who will stand up for them and be able to speak about who they are. Who are you going to be able